Hi, I'm Lyle Unger. I teach at the University of Pennsylvania, where I study natural language processing, mostly trying to understand people better and help them to live healthier, happier, more fulfilling lives. I also co-teach with Conrad Cording our main deep learning course. Today, I want to talk to you about regularization, one of the key techniques in deep learning. So we're going to focus today on supervised learning. And the goal in supervised learning is generalization. In deep learning, we minimize the error on a training set. We adjust the weights to minimize the error. We usually use a really complex model, hundreds of thousands, millions, billions of adjustable parameters. But what we care about is not fitting the training set, but we care about the accuracy, the error on a future test set. We want to fit some sense the signal in the training data, not the noise. And to do this, we'll use a complex model with lots of ways to control that complexity. Why not use a simpler model? Well, we'll talk about that, but the short answer is it works better to use a fancy model and then regularize. Controlling model complexity is the game today. If you use too simple a model, it will tend to underfit the data. It won't capture all the signal in the data. So if you look at this simple data, it says quadratic data with some noise in it. If I fit a line to it, the blue line fits sort of well, but if we used a fancier model, we could probably capture more of the data. This is often in math terms called bias. The simple models systematically give too small weights and too small predictions. If you were to take another similar data set generated from the same source, red dots here, fit the model again, looks pretty similar, and again, it's too low. The predicted y's as a function of x are always below the real ones. So we're seeing that if too simple a model tends to underfit it, it doesn't capture all the signal in the noise in the data. On the other hand, if I fit now a quadratic model to that same data, it fits it really well, low bias. But it's going to be fitting noise in it. It's going to tend to overfit. It will overfit in the sense that if you say, how well does this model do on future test data, it will do less well than it did on the training data. If you have a complicated model, you can fit the noise in the data and then tend to generalize poorly. This is often spoken of being high variance. Variance in the sense that if you fit the noise in the data, if you pull a second data set from the same distribution, the red dots here, and if you fit a different model, the same equational form, but you get a different model and you can see sort of in this area around minus x equals minus one, due to random fluctuation, the orange-red model, much higher than the blue model. So here we have a complicated model, fourth order model in this case, fitting the data really well, fitting the data too well so that it doesn't generalize. The name of the game today, pick the right model complexity. The fancy term will be regularized to control it. What we're adjusting is in some sense the capacity of the neural net. How much information can it represent? At the left-hand side of this curve, we have very simple models. We will underfit. We'll make predictions that are almost just a constant. We won't capture the signal in the data. As the model gets more and more complicated, more and more weights in the neural net, for example, or less and less, we'll see regularization. Then the capacity of the network gets higher and higher. It can fit at first more and more signal, then more and more noise. The bias, the error on the training set goes down, down, down. The variance, the variation from test set goes up, up, up. And what we care about, the generalization error, this red curve, goes down at first and then up. Our goal is to pick the right amount of complexity that gives us the best generalization. So, to summarize, what did we see? Well, we can look here at fitting three different models of different levels of complexity. The blue linear model underfits, it's too simple, doesn't capture the signal in the data. The green quartic model fits too well, from time to time, at each different data set, it varies. And in the middle is this orange line, in this case quadratic, fits the data just with the right amount of complexity. And that's what we'll do today, is tune the complexity of our models. Try and fit not too much noise, but just enough noise. And there's a link to a CoLab notebook if you want to play with these things later. Okay? So linear, quadratic, quartic. In our case, we'll look at hundreds of thousands or millions of weights, but the same idea holds. Okay, so what's the idea? In neural nets, we're going to tend to use incredibly complex models, often more parameters, more adjustable weights than observations. If you do this, you should be able to massively overfit. If I have 100 patients, each with brain images with 40,000 voxels, I'm trying to classify Alzheimer's, not Alzheimer's, I should be able to fit the training data perfectly with a complex model. I could look at the voxel, three voxels down, two over, and five to the side. If that's black versus white, then it's Alzheimer's, right? Each one individual feature would be enough to tell apart all these patients. But that's not what we want. That's overfitting. It's fitting the noise. We want a model that will learn the underlying pattern of how Alzheimer's brains are different from non-Alzheimer's and to be able to fit them. Now, amazingly, and we'll see today, if you fit on, say, images, brain images, any sorts of images, it is the case that you can train a neural net to give zero training error, which should be way overfitting, should do horribly, and yet still get small test error on future brains or images if we do things right. You could also fit pure randomized noise. If you randomly permute the labels on the brains, are they Alzheimer's or not, you can still memorize sheer randomness. So we have sort of too much power. One of the mysteries we'll try and unravel a little today is how is it that we can overfit a bit and still do well. If you look at modern natural language processing models like GPT-3, my current favorite one, there's 175 billion weights trained on 500 billion words of text. That's almost enough to memorize all of the words it sees. It can actually have stored up, this is the pattern, the sequence of words that's there. And if we look at, does it do that? If you ask GPT a prompt, an input, what do you call a droid that takes the long way around? It will then predict what words might follow. R2 detour. Okay, so why is that memorization? I don't think GPT-3 understands how humans think and understands all about R2 D2 and understands how the words sound. It has memorized this, it's seen it on the web and recalled it. So lots of these models, in some sense, memorize images, sequences of text, things they've seen, and figure out how to use them in the right place. Today, we need to figure out how to make them memorize enough so they do a good job of recognizing patterns, but not memorize too much so that they are just overfitting pure noise and not generalizing to different sequences of questions. So the key to all of this, regularization, penalties, methods to control the complexity. Again, what we will see is modern neural nets should overfit incredibly because they have often more parameters in them than training observations, but they don't do as badly as you might think. We'll see why. And if you want to do really well on these giant networks, you need to do lots of regularization. So what is regularization? We'll see lots of ways of controlling overfitting. We'll see penalties like putting in a L1 or L2 penalty, a sum of absolute values or sum of squares of weights. We'll see early stopping of training. We'll see data augmentation techniques. We'll see that stochastic gradient descent itself rather magically does regularization. We'll cover dropout. We'll see that all these things involve hyperparameters that have to be tuned. And then, for fun, at the end, we'll look at adversarial attacks and how to defend against them using regularization. This notion that people can tweak inputs very slightly and get different outputs than should have been there. Okay, this is a lot, But we do have a day to cover it. Let's get started.